Ощущение у самой сменил.
A finalist here last year, lost to Justine Henin. He's been a Grand Slam champion, US Open. And on court, Philippe Chatrier, Amélie Mauresmo still off court. Treatment with a doctor, interrupting her match against Safarova. Slovakian teenager Cibulková. Huge breakthrough in her career here. Things does not want to be broken here.
No, behind the baseline, big forehand.
Again, the big forehand, the heavily topspun forehand of Kuznetsova doing the damage. So a match point for the number three seed.
Heavy kick serve. Got the short reply, allowing for the big forehand.
Asking the question there. Now over on court, Philippe Chatrier. Amélie Mauresmo has just returned to the court and will be heading back there shortly. This match at a vital stage. What a situation on match point. Cibulková holding her breath. Is there a grain of play there? It's called good. Reluctantly walking up to end her French Open campaign. And Svetlana Kuznetsova through in straight sets over the qualifier. Valiant in defeat, Dominika Cibulková.
Defending champion Rafael Nadal was worked harder than the score suggested against Frenchman Albert Montand.
Ah!
This is pretty much how he's played the whole match. He has just taken every opportunity that he's had to hit a winner, he's gone for it. Now, he's hit a lot of winners, but as you might expect, he's made plenty of errors in the process. But he actually hasn't let Nadal dictate to him quite as much as you would have expected. He's served a lot of doubles. On plenty of occasions, he's just basically thrown in two first serves. Interesting tactic. But in the end, the scoreline the same.
Way outside the singles alley, that one, and it's not in until it zips into the corner, as Wally would say, right down the line. Not going to go away, Montañez.
On the guns.
30-15. Hewitt's leading two sets to one. This one looks as though it may be coming to a close. Montañez will not go away as he battles with Rafael Nadal. 2-5, 30-all. Montañez serving. Slap that one.
That was a tired shot, wasn't it? And Montañez, you suspect, Fred, he's played about as well as he can play. And have a look at the scoreline there. I think he needs about 15 more kilos on his frame and about 3 or 4 inches in height to deal with Nadal effectively.
It's match point. The crowd love him. He's given them their money's worth today.
He hasn't held back, has he? Any time he's had a three-quarter ball or anything that's half a chance, he has just thrown everything he's got into it.
Pretty vicious.
He just has a little look at this ball there, landing on the line as he played the drop shot, but he continued to run, so the moment you do that, it's in play, and that's that vicious forehand. Hit with real intent.
Match point once more. Error, but he gave the crowd a lot of enjoyment this afternoon. Did Albert Montañez. Took a hiding, 6-1, 6-3, 6-2, but look at that. 2 hours and 29 minutes, 2.5 hours. Pretty impressive.
Meanwhile, on court, Susan Longlong, number 6 seed Novak Djokovic, was pushed to 5 sets against another Frenchman, Olivier Patience. Well, it was a close run thing. He nearly lost the match in the fourth set. The Serbian is through in 5 tough sets against Olivier Patience of France. And finally today, with the sun well and truly set, the two-time Grand Slam winner Leighton Hewitt may have lost the first set against Jaakko Niemelän, but the Aussie bounced back, and here he serves for the match.
No, he thinks it's long.
And it's up the line. No. Right in the corner.
An ace, Niemelän accepts that. A little bit of applause there at the right time for Hewitt. Match point.
Oh, Well, as you said, it's the last roll of the dice for Neiman, taking plenty of chances. Yeah, a little unlucky there too. Got a bad bounce there. Short wall off the frame, hard to defend against.
Another good first serve. Makes the game so much easier to get that first serve in. And that one's got Hewitt to another match point. Perseverance is rewarded for the 14th seed, Leighton Hewitt. Comes back from a set down. Come through and win that one. 2 hours and 58 minutes. He wins it in four sets.
So let's check the results of the day. Good wins for Rafael Nadal and Novak Djokovic. Carlos Moyer and Jonas Björkman prove that age means nothing. Good wins also for Anna Ivanovic and Svetlana Kuznetsova. Tomorrow's order of play, the headline act sees Roger Federer take on Mikhail Yuzhny and Nikolai Davidenko up against David Nalbandian, while Justin Enna and Yelena Yankovic are also on court. So just 16 men and 16 women remain in the hunt for the two titles at Roland Garros. The forecast is for perfect sunshine and the crowds will be out in force tomorrow. Till then, au revoir, à demain.
On the Five Guns West attack, they shrined for grief on the Gillen.
Sunshine came softly through my window today.
At Bulmers.
It'll take time, I know it.
This has always been the perfect time to put everything on ice. Bulmers Original Cider. Time dedicated to you.
You don't just take a break in Ireland. You let it take you. DiscoverIreland.ie. Right here, right now.
When things heat up, now you've got new Palmolive Soft and Gentle Eden Antiperspirant. It's body responsive and gives 24-hour effective protection with fresh exotic fragrances. So instead of wilting in the heat, you're in your own paradise. New Palmolive Soft and Gentle Eden. Pass it on. It keeps you cool and fresh. Escape to your own paradise with new Palmolive Soft and Gentle Eden Antiperspirant.
You would never clean your kitchen with a dirty sponge, so why wash your dishes in a dirty dishwasher? Even if it looks clean, grease and limescale builds up to block the drain. Finish dishwasher cleaner dissolves dirt and limescale and then carries on working even down your drain. A cleaner dishwasher means cleaner dishes. Finish dishwasher cleaner. Bad smells in your dishwasher? Stop. Try new Finish Odor Stop. It doesn't just cover up bad smells, it targets the odor molecules directly to leave a breath of fresh air. New Finish Odor Stop.
It's Neuex Newman's kitchens for decks and doors. It's Neuex Newman's kitchens for decks and doors.
Neuex Newman's have the know-how when it comes to kitchens, floors, decking, and doors. Visit our showrooms on the North Road, Finglas, Ballymount, Tralee, or Ennis, and see our excellent range for yourself.
It's Neuex Newman's kitchens, floors, decks, and doors.
Fáinne Gillin in seo ar TG Cahar a tacht ar bálín soscail fóric ag leahuaréis a seacht. Díroch roimh sin siar ó thua ag a seacht agus neart Aussie Rules le feicalaí tráthnóna a tosaí ó leahuaréis a cúig ar aghaidh ach a dtí sin an Westron, Five Guns West.
Waco! Alamore, Princep Peak.
All right, get out of there. The Confederate Army was hard up for men. Didn't realize how bad.
Quiet down.
Hush up, man. I'm gonna be a comrade in arms.
Sergeant, get these men ready. All right. William Parcel Candy, convicted of waylaying, robbing, and murdering a party of four persons on the trail of San Antonio. Sentenced to be hanged by the neck until dead. By the authority vested in me, I declare you pardoned. J. John Morgan Candy, suspected of complicity in the murders committed on the trail to San Antonio by his brother, William Candy. Acquitted June 12, 1867. On June 14th, attempting to free his brother from prison, shot and killed two law enforcement officers. Convicted of murder. Sentenced to hang by the neck until dead. Pardoned. J.C. Haggard, while driving a herd of cattle to New Orleans in defiance of the law, was challenged by a troop of Confederate cavalry.
All right, try to stop me.
He ordered his herders to drive the cattle on by force. Two soldiers of the troop and five cowboys were killed.
Good boys, too. He'd lose them.
Convicted of resisting arrest and causing the deaths of seven men. Sentenced to 20 years at hard labor.
Never would have made it. Too old to be pinned up.
Pardoned. Hale Clinton. Shot and killed an unarmed man in an argument over cards. Convicted and sentenced to be hanged by the neck until dead. Pardoned. Governor Sturgis, professional highwayman and gunman, held up the stage en route to Houston and murdered the driver, shotgun, and three passengers. Convicted of murder. Sentenced to be hanged by the neck until dead. Pardoned. Take one step forward, raise your right hands, and repeat after me. I do solemnly swear.
I do solemnly swear.
That I will abide by the laws, rules, and regulations.
I will abide by the laws, rules, and regulations.
Set down by the commands and articles of war.
Set down by the commands.
You know a place called Dawn Springs?
Mining town. About 4 days' ride north of here.
Well, it's abandoned now, except as a midpoint in the stage line. An agent cares for the relief horses. The stage will arrive there about the 18th of the month, carrying a man named Stephen Jethro.
18th? That's cutting it pretty close. That's a hard ride by direct route. That territory is full of Indians out to make war.
That's why we pardon men with your special talents. Jethro was head of the Southern Intelligence Bureau operating beyond the lines. He's gone over to the enemy. That stage has to be stopped on its way from California to Fort Mahan, where Jethro's to turn the information he has over to the Union commandant.
How do you want him?
Alive, if possible. Dead, if need be.
What else do you know?
We know the stage is unscheduled and will be escorted by Union cavalry.
Well, let's see now. All we have to do is make a hard 4-day ride in about 3 days, get through the Staked Plains full of Indians looking for white scalps, cross over the Union lines, hold up a stage escorted by Yankee troops, and then bring some traitor all the way back here for Southern justice. That is quite an order, Captain.
You've traded your chances with a hangman for the chances of the trail. But Jethro, what he knows about Southern agents and the $30,000 he's carrying must not be allowed to reach the Union authorities.
There's $30,000, Captain. That in gold bullion or Confederate scrip?
It's hard money, badly needed for the cause. It's part of Jethro's assignment to provide operating funds for the individual agents.
Captain, we're certainly going to try to get to this Dawn Springs and keep that traitor from reaching Fort Mahan.
Those killers can do the job?
The Southern soldiers now.
Think those patriots can do the job?
They don't do it for reasons of patriotism. They've got 30,000 other reasons to do it. Jethro must be stopped.
Trailblazer, which way now?
That way is longer. It's shorter down by the riverbed. There's a better chance of bumping into Indians.
Not much of a chance this far south. Might as well pick up miles while we can.
You making up our minds for us?
I'm just making up my own mind. That's the way I'm going. Anybody don't want to come along, don't have to.
A couple of more days, we'd have been swinging from a tree like that one there.
They got other trees other places. Keep on pulling fool killings and they'll fit one to your size.
You got no call to holler at me. I did what you said.
Yeah, 3 miles from where I told you I'd be waiting.
So what's the bad? We ain't swinging, are we?
Shut up.
You're always telling me shut up. I got things to say sometimes.
Well, Hale, I figure you can take whichever route you like. I'm going the short way. I don't want to be late for that gold.
You hear what the captain said about dead or alive?
Seems your little brother's gonna have himself some fun.
He ain't never killed legal before.
You seem to have made yourself leader of this little group, Govern. It's all right with me. Just don't get any ideas once the gold's in our hands. It'll be up to you what happens to it.
Well, I'll get what's coming to us.
Seems to be a lot of talk about something we ain't got yet. Still plenty of trail up ahead. Plenty of Indians, deserters from both sides, and Union cavalry. Not to mention the killing things that nature provides. Four or five days. Comanche.
Pretty far south.
The war gives the Indians plenty of time to move and lots of places to go.
Tell to no one. We'll make camp here. Think it's wise to build a fire with the Indians so close?
Figure they're far enough away not to see it. They're still around here. They know we're here anyhow. I need some wood.
Hey, Shorty. Get some wood for the fire.
Don't call me Shorty. I don't like for anybody
get
to
get some
call...
wood.
Look at it burn. Reminds me. Some of the flames red like that girl's hair was.
Girl?
Girl on the road to San Antonio. Look, John. See how it changes color? Looks like blood now. Like red hair and blood.
Just think it, don't say it.
It's loco.
I'll kill you.
You ought to thank him instead. Look.
Thanks.
Morning.
Morning.
Thanks. Good coffee.
A lot better than that gun oil they make in prison. Are you from the Houston Calaboose, or they pick you up from some other place?
All jails have got four walls and bars.
They gonna carry your sense out soon?
Pretty soon.
Not very talkative, are you?
I don't figure talk about getting my neck stretched is breakfast conversation.
Young Candy's loco.
I wouldn't say that too loud.
Billy might decide one of us looks like a rattler.
His brother will keep him hobbled.
Seems like old times. Coffee in the morning on the trail. Miss the cattle balling, though.
Like the ones you were running to the Yankees?
Son, you got away looking for trouble, ain't you?
Not me, old-timer. I'm a peace-loving man.
We can shoot them all right now. Grab their guns and horses and meet the stage ourselves.
There's three of them, all fast with a gun. We can't take them all.
We can get them off alone, one by one.
I want that gold that's laying up north. There's a lot of country to travel. And there'll be Union cavalry to fight. We'll have time enough to cut down on after we get the stage.
I fought the heat, I fought the cool.
My kids died of plague.